I've made a copy of ODB50 and I'm calling this one ODB51 ListBox ValueList. We're going to create another list box, but this time, instead of pulling from existing data to fill our list box, we want to have a list of values that we type in and are held in the form itself. We'll start with a single table. I'll come down to our single table form here, ODB50 single table list box. Right click, copy, right click, paste. And we'll change the name to ODB51 list box value list. I'm going to right click on our new form and edit that. I'm going to turn off our wizards, then click on the list box. And I want to add a list box down here for group. It's looking a little low, so I'm going to select both the department and the group, move them up a little. Now just select that group list box that I want to add. Right click on that. Open up the controls. Go into our data tab. The data field that we want is group. Input required, yes. Value list, yes. Now let's click on that list content. And I'm going to paste in. The top one is just holding down shift and hitting enter to give it that blank line. That's going to be for the nulls. Then we've got our group names, unknown group A, B, C, and D. These values will be what is updated on the group table. Let's go over into the general tab. Come down to list entries. Clicking that, I want to type in the same thing. And this is what will show up in our list box. It will make more sense in our next example why we do things this way. Because we have a single table, our list entries in the general tab should be the same as our list content in the data tab. Close that. Let's go down to design mode. So far it looks good. Looks good. We've got group B and group B. Let's change this to group D. Save, and it updates our group text box. We'll try one more, group A. And that gets updated. So our single table value list text box is working. Let's save this form and closes. Now we want to add a value list to a normalized form. So I'll take this ODB48, right click, copy, right click, paste. We'll give this a new name. We'll call this ODB51 employee edit list box. I'll right click and edit that. Before I do anything, let's go down to design mode, make sure everything's working okay. And it looks like I'm having some problems with the list box I created in ODB48. Let's go back into edit mode and see what's happening. Do I want to save changes? No. I'll click on our list box. And then come down and open up the control from the toolbar. And it looks like we lost our list content. Let's change our list content from SQL to SQL native. Then I'm going to click on the dialog box. I'm going to paste in my SQL. And save it from here. I think it didn't save my SQL because I didn't enter it into the dialog box. So I believe hitting that save should work. And I'll save our form. Let's go back into the dialog, make sure that that looks like it's working. Okay, marketing, marketing. Now let's go on to adding our new list box. This time, I'm actually going to turn on the wizards just so we can see what happens when I do it that way. Clicking on list box, we want to add in the group. And our list box wizard pops up. We really don't need this, so I'm just going to cancel out. Right click, click on control. Our data field will be the group ID. Input required, yes. Type of list content will be value list. And we want our list content. I want this to be 0, shift enter, 1, shift enter, 2, shift enter, 3, shift enter, 4. And if I hit shift enter again, that would give me a null, which I do not want because we do not have nulls available for our normalized database. So the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, one of these values will be what is put into the group ID on the table. When we go over to general, down at list entries, this will be what shows up in our list box. And I'm going to paste in the values. Unknown, group A, group B, group C, and group D. I'll close this. Let's go down to design mode and see if it's working. We have group A. Make this group C. When I save it, we see our group name gets updated to group C. When I update this to unknown, save, and our group name is now unknown. I will save this form and save the database.